One scene, one shot, one take.
TSA has recently instituted a policy of random searches aboard international flights.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for another Top 10 Continuous Movie Shots.
Captain, you might want to hear this.
I need everybody to place both hands on the seat in front of you.
What the hell is he doing?
For this list, we're looking at scenes that aren't interrupted by even a single cut, or at least appear not to be, which can often be a director's way of highlighting a movie's meticulous timing, great choreography, or the talent of the actors in a single take.
What's your name?
Tom Bowen. Why? Man, take it easy. Ow!
Move.
I didn't do anything.
If you didn't see a shot you thought should be on here, be sure to check out our first video of the top 10 continuous uninterrupted shots in movies.
I have a suspect in custody. I need a background check. Seat 24E, Tom Bowen, B-O-W-E-N.
Number 10, one shot shootout, breaking news. Hong Kong director Johnny To breaks ground with this action film's opening scene, which is not only a cut-free tracking shot, but also one full of complicated crane-based camera work. Even before the bullets fly, it's hard to believe that there aren't any optical illusions or editing techniques that cheat at the remarkable achievement of being completely uninterrupted. And it's not just use of style for its own sake. It's a plot-relevant display of how the police force can fail miserably to catch these crooks under the unblinking eyes of live television. Number 9. Move to the music, Kill Bill Volume 1. This shot from the first Kill Bill took 6 hours to rehearse and 17 takes, but the Steadicam operator made it look easy. Paced in time to the music, we travel over narrow walls and ceilings with the camera. One wall actually needed to be removed during the shot to bring in the crane that gets the cameraman into the restroom. When the wall is quickly replaced, he blindly travels backwards by ground. Meanwhile, stagehands rush to build a ramp, which takes us to the top of the staircase after the singer's close-up. Number 8, one-way trip, Magnolia.
You okay? Busted my ankle there.
Paul Thomas Anderson loves his long takes, and Magnolia has quite a few.
There you are.
Sorry we're late, Cynthia.
There you are. No, that's all right.
You got caught in traffic.
That's okay. How you doing, Stanley?
I'm fine.
Yes? Yeah, you ready to go, go, go?
A good one is this tracking shot through the TV station that hovers through the hallways from one character to the next.
He's ready to beat the record.
That was close.
There's cats and f***ing dogs out there.
Cats and dogs, indeed.
I've never seen it rain this bad since last year. He's a La Nina or El Nino or whatever the shit. No bueno, no El Nino.
While most tracking shots this elaborate are used to establish the setting, this one's notable for creating a sense of kinetic energy in its people instead.
Where's the news department at the studio?
It's upstairs.
Have you ever been there?
Oh, sure, why?
Well, I was wondering about the weather department.
Uh-huh.
I was wondering whether or not the weather people have outside meteorological services or if they have in-house instruments.
The fact that it's unbroken also keeps us in the immediacy of it, like a reminder that we're heading in with no way out.
Rose is on the phone. Here are the cards for today.
15 minutes ago, where were those cards?
Sorry.
I need you to find Paula for me.
You want her right now?
Yes, now.
We're on the air in 20 minutes, Jimmy.
You know, Mary. Yeah.
Number 7. Best seats in the house, the secret in their eyes.
Uno de los candidatos a ganar el título.
Arranca Jorge, lleva la pelota, deja en el camino a Brindisi. Gran maniobra, va llevando la pelota por izquierda, ataca al equipo de Racing. Elude perfectamente Coleman.
Over 20 technicians toiled for 9 months of digital work to make this long take look as impossibly realistic as it does from its bird's eye view downward. This Oscar-winning crime film from Argentina sports a 5-minute showdown between the FBI and their suspect, Isidoro Gomez, at a Full House football stadium mid-game.
No! Te parió! Gomez! Vení! Vení, cagón! No corras! Vení acá!
It keeps us glued to every moment of the chase it's been leading to, with a sequence that makes for good suspense by appearing to be uncut. Number 6, Fallow the Leader, The Bonfire of the Vanities.
Ah, Mr.
Hi, Mr. Fallow. Welcome. Oh, yes. Please.
Step right out right here.
This way. Hi. So nice to see you.
Yes, it is.
Bruce Willis's portrayal of alcoholic writer Peter Fallow sees him being paraded through stardom and press coverage as filmed by Larry McConkey, the same Steadicam operator responsible for the Kill Bill shot in our number 9 entry.
But I must say, Mr. Fallow, if I may quote you. How in the name of God, who in the name of God would bring a half-eaten jar of mayonnaise to public meeting ambassador?
This scene led to several injuries and took 12 takes from dusk till dawn to shoot.
Are you hungry?
No.
That's salmon, but I really don't think you should touch that. Oh.
Mr. Fallow, it's just such an honor to finally meet you. Oh my God!
The entire sequence stands out for its collaborative effort between cast and crew, especially with this many moving parts and extras.
What's your name?
Suzanne.
You married me?
Oh.
Hey, Mr. Fowler!
Excuse me!
Mr. Fowler!
Excuse me! Excuse me!
The fact that it's also dialogue heavy makes it very impressive.
Let's go, let's take this. Someone needs deodorant.
Mr. Fowler, I would just like to...
All right. Here we go. Everything is under control.
Number 5, Walk This Way, Raging Bull. It's been hailed as a Martin Scorsese classic for good reason. The Jake LaMotta story about a boxer's obsession with violence is an unflinching, unwavering look at his character. One sequence that particularly highlights the tough guy's focus and dedication is the unbroken take that follows him into the ring for his title fight. Psychologically, this slow-paced type of character study both contrasts and complements the assault that follows, making the blows the fighters exchange more visceral than anything this scene could prepare us for. Number 4, Keep It Moving, Strange Days.
Good.
What are you, crazy man? Wait till I get this thing down. You're trying to ID me?
What you doing?
Fucking retard.
A fast-paced, violent, one-take robbery reminds its audiences of the frailty and sensitivity of life and human nature.
Go! Go! Crush that coat!
And you can't help but panic right along with these guys as they mobilize their botched heist, both in and outdoors.
Hands in the air! No. Where you going, bitch? Where you going? Over here! Get the you! Open the
fucking register! Now!
The 35mm camera was custom built to be light, which might be why this shot looks like it's an odd version of the human eye.
Get inside, you sucker!
Did you get the money?
Yes!
Yes! What are you doing, you
Come on, man! We gotta go!
Our eyes dart around faster than traditional film cameras would encourage, and the found footage simulation here makes the whole thing slightly surreal.
Come on, grab my hand! Come on, man!
Number 3. Long walks on the beach. Atonement.
Just arrived, sir. Can you tell us what we're supposed to be doing?
Nothing, just wait.
Where are the ships?
When British soldier Robbie traipses across the war-torn Dunkirk beach, it doesn't get more elaborate than 1,000 extras and several horses choreographed to contribute to the sum of this long take's intricate parts. With little dialogue, what makes this tracking shot interesting, besides all the coordinated cues, is its cinematography. Since the extras were only available for a day, that's exactly how much time they had to shoot the scene. And it took 3 takes, along with the complete exhaustion of their crew, to get it right. Number 2. Going nowhere, gravity.
Houston, I have a bad feeling about this mission.
Please expand.
Okay, let me tell you a story.
The foreboding doom of the explorer's impending assault by satellite debris is played out in torturous real time, forcing its audience to watch the crew hastily prepare for the trouble that's a few minutes away.
Visual examination doesn't reveal any damaged components. The problem must be originating from the comms panel.
If you're not easily rattled by the tension of their situation, the swelling music certainly helps.
Gotta admit one thing. Can't beat the view.
The long take is one of director Alfonso Cuarón's trademarks, but with the confines and conflict of space's altered physics, never has this film technique been so nerve-wracking. Especially when disaster does strike.
We need to get the hell out of here. Need some help there, man.
No, don't wait for us.
Stop it.
Man down.
Houston, the
man down.
Copy. Houston, the
floor. Copy. Before we track our top pick, here are some honorable mentions.
Is this Debbie Robinson? Do you recognize him?
I never knew him.
You know, I'm kind of tired. I could use a foot massage myself.
Yo, man, you best back off. I'm getting a little pissed here. This is the door.
Yeah, it is.
Number 1, underground and pound, Hannah. If Eric Bana looks nervous, it might be genuine. A dolly, Steadicam, and other camera equipment are tracking him, completely dependent on the perfect performance both before and during the pressure-filled moments of his fight scene in Hannah. Director Joe Wright, a fan of those continuous shots and also responsible for the one in Atonement, claims this stylistic sequence was efficient for his budget constraints.
We got it. Picking up now.
An added challenge was the 45-minute magic hour lighting limitation to film shortly after sunrise, which was successfully achieved within 6 or 7 takes. Do you agree with our list? Which continuous movie shots did we miss? For more uncut top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.